So what's up, the Fine Back Girls? Today got a really, 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 really quick Duck and Bow video I want to do. So really quick, we did get a lot of new news for Global right now. We are getting the Beer Duck and Fest event is confirmed, fully confirmed, everything like that for Global. We should come out in the next few weeks slash days. I want to say around next week time, around this time for Global, because yeah, Global always used to just like get a download slash celebration almost always on Sundays and Mondays we usually do. So yeah, beer should be there. Then I want to say, because I know we're gonna get like easy and stuff like that. Technically we should, but after that, Global's gonna head to the anniversary stuff. Then after that, Global's gonna head to the download celebration slash download celebration and stuff like that, like 300 to 350 mil downloads. I'll plug Global head into that next. And after that, October we'll probably see like all around about Kremlin and probably into the Rage Trunks. And then on top of that, I want to say for November we'll definitely gonna see Golden Week stuff. Then maybe December we'll see Capital. Because last year, this Kid Goku is the 8th Goku Duck Fest unit. It comes out around this time, so kind of just makes sense where it kind of factors in though. So that's good though. I mean, at least because after the anniversary units, they always tend to like bring these type of units anyway. They always do this no matter what anyway. Last year with Kid Goku, this year with Beerus. So next year when we get the next year, 6th year anniversary unit, we'll see after the freaking bit my tongue. I bit my sock. Really freaking hurt. Okay, that really hurt a little bit. But yeah, next year, I don't know, when we get, next year, Dr. Fest unit will be, but I don't know, like, a sword, a Mecha Freezer or whatever, or, Trunks that would beat Freezer, Mecha Freezer. He could be a Dr. Fest next year, and boom, we could, see, the next unit right here. I don't know, I'm just saying, yeah, his teaser wasn't in the game as well. Then, of course, again, Beerus is, top five, for me. Him, Beerus, and I'm gonna hit Beerus. Yeah, Beerus, Cooler, and Bardock. Yeah, Beerus, Bardock, and Cooler, I do put them all in the same category. Because again, the Bardock is just Beerus and Cooler combined. Before transforms and stuff like that, after transforms, second defense, stuff like that, before he transforms. Again, a little stuff like that, of course. And yeah, then after that, I put Vegeta below at 1, because again, the best TUR slash, EZA, whatever way you put it in there. Because again, he means Cooler, Beerus, and Bardock in a lot of tiers. I'm sorry, he really does, he's the best TUR in the game. I can't say that, I really can say that with confidence. I'll say Engine Nymph was on there, but not that really anymore. Like, I don't know if people love Engine Nymph, because yeah, he tanks, he dodges. It's just STR Engine Nymph. They always, AZU is always take away from the Dokkan Fest concourse. Usually before or after, like the Ray Trunks and stuff like that. Again, though, going back and forth. Yeah, Violent Death Story Man is going to be revamped. I'm going to go over all this stuff when it comes out, because I like to do that, like going over everything that comes out. Realm of Gods will be the, of course, the category that actually does more drops, so yeah, you basically want to use a whole Realm of Gods. And for JP at this time, we already had like El Gogeta and Vegeta, which were all on Realm of Gods. We had Goku Black, I think. Zamasu Goku Black, he was on Realm of Gods. Again, just units and stuff like that. El Vegeta, the blue STR one. Again, though, yeah, a lot of little stuff like that, but of course, yeah, those two events are going to come up for Global. Again, though, Battle Gods getting a revamp. So we went from Farmer Goku before he leaves, we already did that beforehand. I think around the time of Beerus was came out for JP, so I was like, I'll farm him out, because, at that point, the unit, unit's not attainable anymore, with, like, these events and stuff like that get revamped. Because it's like, this Goku right here, he goes from a Farmer Goku to this Goku. Then he goes from this Goku to this Goku, God Goku, and back to Super Saiyan. Because even though, God and stuff like that got power, because, it's basically all, supposed to be all, the Battle of Gods movie. So basically, it's like, hey, Goku used his God Key and stuff like that. This is him, battling Beerus a lot. So yeah, again, around Global timeline, this does kind of fit, though. Again, though, Beerus, Beast, God, Goku. This Vegeta should be getting his EZA sooner than later. He really is a good unit against World of God's enemies. The Tech Suppression unit should be getting the Awakenings. Not too long from Global right now, the Global should have a World Tournament. Then we have that Jackie Chun, but yeah, Global already has all that other stuff down there. That is like LR Prime Battle, Krillin, LR Vegeta, and Nappa. Again, the little units and stuff like that that Global should get soon. In the course of Battlefield, should be getting revamped soon. The next little enemies and stuff like that. And then just the Explosion of Anger category for Beerus. It really is a good category, just that there's a lot of units still missing, like, LR Gohan, the AGL one, the Super Saiyan 2 Gohan's on here. He didn't need to win the Anger. I guess we're kind of this guy because, Super Saiyan 1. Is he on Explosion of Anger? I don't know if they changed that. But yeah, they should change it, because they, again, though, the 8th Kid Goku was on full power, 21 was on 50 Gauss. Again, though, they changed units and stuff like that constantly. So I don't know why. I mean, again, though, going and exploding in anger, after self-beating. It kind of just makes sense, because, Super Saiyan 1 Gohan didn't explode. I mean, he did explode in anger, of course, the RG16. You know, I just know Crush 16's head. He didn't do any of that. He didn't go and do one to all the Cell Juniors, you know, after he, you know, after they bum rush his friends and stuff like that. He didn't want to kill Cell. Cell roamed the Earth freely and killed everybody. It's fine. It's fine. Yeah, Krillin. Oh, I'm talking about Krillin was trying to explode your anger. It's fine. He didn't explode anger after Yamcha died. He didn't want revenge after Yamcha died. It's all cool. It's all cool. Yeah. All Broly's, Goku, Super Saiyan Goku's on here. The other Broly's, yeah, Dragon Ball Super Broly's on here. But yeah, you know, those categories, it still feels small. It's not that big, but if it's not JP, it hasn't got that much. Has it gotten buffs lately? I can't remember. But, yeah, El Rosa's gonna come out after this, so yeah, he's gonna be on there. He's gonna be on there. Oh, did they? Just one. Close your finger. Okay, I could've sworn they changed that, because I don't think he was on here before. No, it might have been Revenge. It might have been Revenge. Okay, I knew he was on here. I don't know, it's been a minute. I need to go back watch the Beerus video, because I guess when Gohan was on, he was on there before. I definitely knew he was on there before. This AJ Gohan down here. Because when he was on Explosion, it might have been Revenge. It might have been Revenge. I really need to go back watch the Beerus video, because when he came out and stuff like that, I definitely know Gohan. Okay, no, he was on there. I remember now. He definitely was on here. Okay, I had to make sure. I'm remembering now. Yeah, he definitely was on there. Okay, it might have been the Revenge category. Yeah, it was Revenge, not the Scott. But yeah, again, the Beerus, he's in his own tier, though. He's really disgusting, because, again, when you're fighting one with God's units, we're basically using for legendary Goku event, because I think that Goku, I think, because of transforming Goku, I think he has all those specific categories of, you know, like one with gods. All that before he transforms anyway to, like, God, Blue Goku, whatever, or which one you want to call it. Oh, same thing anyway. It's also presented God. But, yeah, though, I feel like definitely, he's going to be good for legendary Goku event. That's what he's going to basically be for. He's going to be playing a lot of good from God's enemies. He's going to be getting Rainbow Keepers a lot. I think, yeah, he's going to change his rainbow to... He's super effective against all types when fighting with God's enemy. So basically, he's going to be doing like 2, 3 million, 4 million damage on his own sometimes. Not cool damage, but around that same kind of tier. He's going to be raising his attack. He's going to keep doing more damage. He's going to raise his defense, you know, defense and attack at the start of the turn. You know, pulling a super attack and stuff like that. So he's going to be good. Again, though, he's brokenly good, brokenly amazing. Against the top 5 units in the game. So yeah, he did come out, yeah, March 3rd. Yeah, that was a long time ago. Yeah, his legs and stuff like that, again, though, it all kind of factors in with. Because, you know, you go in here with Blue Vegito and Gogeta, and you skip Beerus away from come back on coins or something like that. Definitely, I feel like you should do that, though, if you want to, bro. So I don't feel like he's going to come back, like, March, April, May. Probably want to say until, like, June, maybe? I don't know. But yeah, again, though, he's really good. He's really awesome and stuff like that. But yeah, he's going to be good with the, Goku. He's going to be good with, STR Blue Goku. Kaioken Blue Goku. He's going to be good with, Blue Fusions. All of those teams, all good room of gods and Explosion of Anger. So yeah, he's good for those teams and stuff like that. And if you put this Whis by his side, he's gonna dodge everything. This Whis dodges, seals, he basically is a, he's like Spirit Bomb Goku and UI Goku together, essentially. LR Spirit Bomb Goku and UI Goku fuse together. So basically, he's gonna be dodging a lot. And if you put him and Beerus on the same rotation, it's gonna be like, the best rotation in the game. Like him and any other Beerus, like Beerus and Whis also counts both. You can put them on there. This Beerus, you can put Blue Fusions. I mean, this Whis, Blue Fusions, Beerus, the Room of Gods just got a huge buff, especially for Gold Bowl coming up. This is gonna be good, but I still feel like you skip this banner move, because again, the Whis, he's gonna be on every other banner moving forward, and if you're lucky enough to pull him, plus he's gonna be like, you know, like 500, you know, category banners anyway, so I don't recommend swimming for those either, though, but I'm just saying. But yeah, money is better spent for the 5th anniversary, not Beerus or Whis, even though, like, they are some of the best teams in the game. It's Beerus really good, because I know it's gonna definitely hit number 1 for Gold Bowl. Because it hit number 1 for JP, it definitely feels like it hit number 1 for Gold Bowl. But we like Ultra Rewards, because, you know, they've been doing that back and forth lately. You know, good rewards, bad rewards, 7 stones, good stones, whatever. So yeah, basically, you know, with the whole global crisis going on right now, the whole global, you know, worldwide pandemic crisis going on, so it's not because of that, honestly, though. I mean, it can kind of be, if you want to factor that in, but not that much really, though. But again, though, this guy's good, though. Of course, we have new free-to-play God Goku. And this Goku as well. I mean, he's just dope for making Super Saiyan, though. So yeah, they're both good, though. They're both really solid and really good, though. They're gonna be really good against a Roman Gods category enemies. This guy is gonna change Keisters and healing himself up. Again, they're really good solid replay units, though. They're really good, though. But yeah, that's all I really want to go, though, today. Again, the Beerus is, Beerus and stuff like that. His Doki Fest teaser is here. I feel like you guys shouldn't summon, though, and stuff like that. Of course, this is banner. Actually, I meant to go over the banner really quick. But in the video, we'll go over the banner really quick. It's really good, though. But yeah, again, these top 3 units are like the best ones like on here. I guess it's the best thing. Beerus, good. Obviously, yeah, Beerus, you're not gonna use him on the rotation because it doesn't count. But yeah, this Beerus, of course, Whis, Beerus, Core, best three units on this banner. Namagoku, he hasn't been back. No, he has been back. He was on Cool's banner. He's still good, though. He really is still good. I know this team has just gotten better and better with age. The team is just going to keep getting better. Especially with more Super Saiyan category units, just regular Super Saiyans, it's going to be good. I'm sure with Vegeta and Blue Goku, they were just on the Majin Vegeta and Goku banner. I don't think they're going to change it. This Beerus is still good, but, you know, this is Beerus replaces him. But, I mean, if you want to view him and stuff like that, it's still good. But, yeah, though, these guys definitely, I feel like, they were just on Kaioken Blue Goku. I mean, they're just on the Majin Vegeta and Goku banner. So, yeah, I don't think Global's not going to change it. They didn't change Cooler. They changed, they didn't change the name of Goku either. So, they're definitely not going to change the banners. At this point, anyway, why would they change the banners? Because the anniversary is literally about to be around the corner. And they never change those anniversary banners. So, they'll be like, oh, yeah, Cooler's going to be on that banner. Even though, you know, for Global, and Global, context Global, he was just on here. So, it wouldn't make sense him being on the anniversary banner than this banner. Because, again, though, different units and stuff like that. They're not gonna, they never change the anniversary banners anyway. They changed it for the last, like, what, 3, 4, 5 years at this point, so. They never changed anniversary banners. Besides the Full Power Freezer banner and Gogeta banner, because originally Gogeta was supposed to come out first for Global instead of Full Power Freezer, but they changed it up to Global. And those rates were bad, and they showed those rates were horrible. But yeah, this is banner overall. I feel like they're not good. I kind of feel like they might change Transforming Vegeta and Blue Kaioken Goku, but at the same time, they're not, because, again, what's the point of changing them? What's the point of changing these banners anyway? So, I mean, I get they're just on here for Global, literally, like, but at the same time, they don't really need to change it that much. I mean, because no one's going to really sign up for this banner. I mean, a lot of people are, but I don't recommend doing it because 5th anniversary, I know it's tempting. If you want to get Cooler coins, I say go ahead. But at the same time, you know, Blue Fusion and stuff like that. They're going to come back on the 10th of Bonnet anyway. For Global, it's going to be November. For JP, it's going to be July. They always come back around that time. So if you want to save coins for them, I'll probably recommend it. Because I always keep forgetting about that. It's like, oh yeah, let me back with coins. I literally have, like, what, 368 coins at times recording. So it's like, oh, crap. Like, oh, it's a few away to getting Cooler. Probably, like, what, a few more? But it's like, yeah, because I got, like, 400 coins. Again, though, it's just something you'll get a whole bunch of coins anyway. A lot of people are like, when the coins were first coming out, a lot of people are like, oh yeah, it's for whales and stuff like that. It really isn't. It's good for free play units because the more you summon, the more coins you get, the better units you can get. But yeah, again, though, I don't recommend summoning for this banner at all. I do not recommend doing it. Especially Shuffling Goku and Kaioken Blue Goku. They were just on Goku's banner. And plus, again, they've been back on every banner. And Global, they're not going to change these banners at this point. Namek Goku didn't change. I believe so, in by like October 2019. And of course, Cooler, again though, they've changed the banner as well. So yeah, the banner's good. I do not recommend something for it though, but I really don't do it. Trust me, I'm tempting to do it, but I'm not gonna do it. But yeah, that's really it. I want to go over today. Again, the Beerus, his new category is gonna come to Global soon. Beerus and Whis are godly amazing units. This God Goku Super Saiyan Goku is so good. If you want to find my Goku Super Attack easily, here you go. I was gonna say that if you guys should say, because I had a feeling Beerus was gonna be the next Joker Fest event not too long from now, so I was gonna say, oh yeah, you guys should wait, because you know, you can form out your Goku Super Attack. And plus, this Goku right here, of course, you know, you can form out Super Saiyan Goku really easily now. Let's just say with this guy right here, so it's gonna be super easy. I got a lot of Super Saiyan Goku to form out, so yeah. All right, we wanna go those today, again, the Battle Gods revamp. Beerus is coming to Global. What do you guys think? Hopefully, I didn't go too fast, so yeah. See you guys later, though. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day. All cool jokes. Again, though. See you guys later, though. Peace out.